Hi, so in the previous video, we've discussed about uterine fibroids. Now we'd like to talk about another type of growth known as uterine polyps. So uterine polyps are also non-cancerous growths that are found to be growing from the endometrium into the uterine cavity. So their size can vary from very tiny into like seed size, so the size of fruit seeds, or they can grow up to sizes of a golf ball. So the size can vary depending on your condition. So they are usually caused by hormonal factors, hormonal imbalance in the patient's body. So polyps are known to be hormonally sensitive, specifically towards estrogen or progesterone. So mainly because of that, you have a hormonal imbalance in your system, which caused this growing of the polyps. So as long as you deal with the underlying cause, these polyps will stop growing. So what are some of the symptoms of if you have a uterine polyp? So uterine polyp usually is accompanied with the symptom of vaginal bleeding. Common symptom is that women will experience bleeding even though they are not in their period. So if you have this symptom, you may have a uterine polyp. Furthermore, there's another symptom is that people who already experience menopause but they still have vaginal bleeding. So this is a key indication that you may have a uterine polyp present in your uterine cavity. And another symptom that I want to mention is that patients with uterine polyps usually experience excessive bleeding during menses. So what are the treatments for this condition is that we use 3D hysteroscopy to go into the uterine cavity via the cervix and to surgically remove these polyps. Besides that, we need to deal with the primary cause. So as I mentioned before, what is causing the hormonal imbalance in your body? We need to figure out what exactly is triggering this growth of the polyps. So in many cases, especially in our experience, we've realized that polyps are usually caused by PCOS. Of course, there are other diseases that are possibly can trigger uterine polyps, but most commonly PCOS is a very common trigger. So uterine polyps is not actually a disease itself, it's actually a consequence of another underlying cause. So in this case, very likely that you may have PCOS. So PCOS affects the hormonal balance of your uterus. So as long as you deal with the PCOS, which we will also use a laparoscopy to remove the excessive testicular tissue that is found in your ovaries, polyps will no longer grow back. So it's very important to deal with the underlying cause. A lot of medical institutions only deal with the polyps, so they will just surgically remove the polyps. But after a few months, you'll realize that your polyps will relapse. They will start to grow back again because the underlying cause of the hormonal imbalance is not treated. So I hope this video can give you an understanding of what is causing polyps, what type of treatment you need to do to prevent them from coming back.